Some of the examples of nonmetals are carbon, sulfur, iodine, oxygen, hydrogen, etc. The nonmetals are either solids or gases except bromine, which is a liquid. Do nonmetals also have physical properties similar to that of metals? Let us find out. Activity 3.7. Collect samples of carbon, sulfur, and iodine. Carry out the activities 3.1 to 3.6 with these nonmetals and record your observations. Activity 3.7. Samples of carbon, coal or graphite, sulfur and iodine. The table column, element, symbol, type of surface, hardness, malleability, ductility, conduction sheet, electricity, sonority. Carbon symbol C, soft surface, hardness hard, non-malleable, non-ductile, no, heat conduction no, except graphite. Sonority non-sonorous. Sulfur symbol is soft in nature, surface soft, hardness soft, malleability non-malleable, non-ductile, no heat conduction and electric conduction. Sonority non-sonorous. Iodine I, shining liquid, non-malleable, non-ductile, conduction no, does not conduct heat and electricity, sonority non-sonorous. We cannot group elements according to their physical properties alone, as there are many exceptions. For example, all metals except mercury exist as solids at room temperature. In activity 3.5, you have observed that metals have high melting points, but gallium and cesium have very low melting points. These two metals will melt if you keep them on your palm. Iodine is a non-metal, but it is lustrous. Carbon is a non-metal that can exist in different forms. Each form is called an allotrope. Diamond, an allotrope of carbon, is the hardest natural substance known and has a very high melting point and boiling point. Graphite, another allotrope of carbon, is a conductor of electricity. Alkali metals, lithium, sodium, potassium, are so soft that they can be cut with a knife. They have low densities and low melting points. Elements can be more clearly classified as metals and non-metals on the basis of their chemical properties. Activity 3.8. Take a magnesium ribbon and some sulfur powder. Burn the magnesium ribbon. Collect the ashes formed and dissolve them in water. Test the resultant solution with both red and blue litmus paper. Is the product formed on burning magnesium acidic or basic? Now, burn sulfur powder. Place a test tube over the burning sulfur to collect the fumes produced. Add some water to the above test tube and shake. Test the solution with blue and red litmus paper. Is the product formed on burning sulfur acidic or basic? Can you write equations for these reactions? Observation. Magnesium oxide ashes obtained by burning magnesium metal is basic in nature because when litmus test is performed, with its aqueous solution, it turned red litmus blue. Equation 2mg solid state plus O2 gas gives on burning 2mgO solid. MgO plus H2O gives MgOH twice. MgO magnesium oxide, H2O water, MgOH twice magnesium hydroxide. Red litmus solution plus MgOH twice gives blue colored solution. The aqueous solution obtained by dissolving oxide of sulfur SO2 changes blue litmus to red. So it is acidic in nature. S plus O2 on burning gives SO2. SO2 plus H2O gives H2SO3. H2SO3 plus blue litmus solution gives red colored solution. From that we conclude metals form basic oxides and non-metals form acidic oxides. Most non-metals produce acidic oxides when dissolved in water. On the other hand, most metals give rise to basic oxides. In text questions, page number 40, question number 1. Give an example of a metal which, first one, is a liquid at room temperature, second, can be easily cut with a knife, third, is the best conductor of heat, fourth, is a poor conductor of heat. Answer. First one, the metal which is liquid at room temperature is mercury. Number 2, the metals which can be cut with a knife are sodium and potassium. Third, silver metal is the best conductor of heat. Fourth, lead metal is the poorest conductor of heat. Question number 2, explain the meanings of malleable and ductile. Answer, malleable. The property of the metal by which it can be drawn into thin sheet is called malleability, and the metals are called malleable. Ductile. The property of the metals by which they can be drawn into thin wires is called ductility, and the metals are called ductile. Gold and silver are the most ductile and the most malleable metals.